Greetings, friends. It's me, Wayman29. I just come on in response to the Jesus Freak video. What does atheism contribute to society? I believe it creates a balance, a much-needed balance. So when the pendulum swings too far one way into extremism, you have the other calling you on it, and vice versa. And I've seen it happen in the little microcosm of YouTube, and it's brilliant. It also says so in the literature. Probably you don't read because this is false doctrine in the evangelical view, but some of the oldest literature in the Epic of Gilgamesh talks about the same thing. Then Enkidu stepped out, and he stood in the street and blocked the way. Mighty Gilgamesh came on, and Enkidu met him at the gate. He put out his foot and prevented Gilgamesh from entering the house, so they grappled, holding each other like bulls. And they broke the doorposts, and the walls shook. They snorted like bulls locked together. And they shattered the doorposts, and the walls shook. Gilgamesh bent his knee with his foot planted on the ground, and with a turn, Enkidu was thrown. Then immediately his fury died. When Enkidu was thrown, he said to Gilgamesh, "There is not another like you in the world, who is strong as a wild ox. She was the mother who bore you, and now you are raised above all men, and Enli has given you kingship, for your strength surpasses the strength of men." So Enkidu and Gilgamesh embraced their friend, and their friendship was sealed. The balance in mythology needs to be kept between night and day. Horus and Seth battled. Baal and Maat battled. Satan and the Creator battled. Samael from Jewish literature, which later became Satan. The wars in heaven, which is spoken about in Jewish literature and by the Apostle Paul in the New Testament. All that stuff created a balance. Yahweh and the sea battled, and many stories in mythology show this balance, the much needed balance. And in the evangelical view, had it not been for the Satan into the deception into eating of the tree of knowledge, or the tree of knowledge of good and evil, supposedly evangelicals believe we would not even have free will. Had not Christ and Satan battled, supposedly, maybe we would not have salvation, according to the evangelical view. So, it's very important. Secularism, which is what you meant in reality, contributes much to the world. Religion is just one of the tools that is used when promoting slicing and dicing. And while you're adding up the body count, politics, nationalism, and many other things go into it. But I believe that secularism and secularist ideas have saved many more lives than religion has. Because it allows me to think differently than you. And secularism will stop you from slicing my head off for doing so. So, take care, friends, and remember, if everyone's thinking alike, then somebody isn't thinking, and religion and the gift of salvation is not free. It will cost you everything. Your life, your soul, your all. So take care, friends.